Describe the photo. It's election day. Election day in the United States. This is an image of something called the Electoral College Map. Electoral College Map. If you turn on your TV this week, you will see this map with states colored in two or three different colors. The U.S. does not use a popular vote to determine the president. Popular vote. That's where you count every vote in the country, and the person with the most votes wins. Many would say, myself included, that would be a good idea. But that's a discussion for another time. See these numbers on each state? Those are the electoral votes. Electoral votes. Think of them like points in a basketball game. The candidate who arrives to 270 is the winner. Winner. So, where do these points come from? Every state gets 1 point for each senator. Senator. Every state in the U.S. automatically has 2 senators. It's not important how big or small the population is in the state, okay? Everybody gets 2 points to begin. So California, the most populous state, has 39 million people and 2 senators. Wyoming, the least populous state, only has around 586,000 people, but they also have 2 senators. And so, they automatically receive 2 points. This means that a senator in Wyoming represents 293,000 people, while in California, 1 senator represents almost 20 million people. That's not really fair in my opinion, but again, that's a discussion for another time. Okay, so every state has 2 points. The other points come from the population. So, the bigger the population, the more points a state has. That's why California, Texas, and Florida have so many points. This whole electoral college system was a compromise that was agreed on during the foundation of the nation almost 250 years ago. And yes, strange as it is, we still use this old system. So when an American votes, it is very important which state they are in. Let me use my state as an example. I'm from California. California. So this is where my vote is counted. Everyone in California will vote, and one of the 2 candidates will be the winner. That winner will get all 55 points, or electoral votes, from California. Let me repeat that, because it's important. The winner gets all the points from the state. Let's say 15 million people voted for candidate A and 14 million voted for candidate B. That means candidate A is the winner and gets all 55 points from California. Candidate B gets nothing. He loses. All those votes for him get 0 points in the national election. This is the same in almost all of the US. If a candidate wins a state, they get all its points. Only 2 states, Maine and Nebraska, have special systems where they decide to divide the points a little differently. So you will see this map on the news this evening or this week changing between 2 colors. The red color is for the Republican Party. The Republicans. Republicans. This is the party to the right in politics. The blue color is for the Democratic Party. The Democrats. Democrats. This is the party to the left. Now I know red is a color often associated with the left and socialism or communism in Europe. But in the US, the right, the Republican Party, is identified with a red color. This actually only started in the year 2000. Graphic designers simply connected the letter R from red to the R from Republicans and the R from the word right, and this idea stuck. This idea stuck. The Democrats then just got the other color, blue. Here is an updated map from November 2nd, 2020, from CNN. We can see the states they are very sure will vote Democrat in blue. and the states they are very sure will vote Republican in red. All these yellow states are nearer to 50-50. 50-50. And so we are not sure where they will finish. These are called the battleground states. Battleground states. Basically, they are where the election is decided. A state like Florida is extremely important, where the population is almost evenly divided between Republicans and Democrats. So whoever gets just 1% more will get all of these 29 points. One final thing to note for the 2020 election is that many people voted by post, by mail. Mail. Interestingly, more Democrats vote by mail, while more Republicans vote in person. There are complicated reasons why this is so, but one of them is related to coronavirus. More Democrats have been encouraged to vote from home at a safe distance, while Republicans have encouraged voters to go to vote in person. Each state will count all of these millions of votes by mail in different ways. Some of the states have been counting the votes as they arrive, so they will have a good number to show on election night. But others are not allowed to start counting those post votes until November 3rd. So they will need many days to count them all and get an accurate number. This has all created a big danger. Danger. Depending on how the votes are counted, one candidate will look like he is winning much more than the other. If you count mail-in votes first, Joe Biden will be doing very well. If you count in-person voting, Donald Trump will look like he is winning. So, there is a danger that Donald Trump will declare victory before all the mail-in votes are counted. What does all this mean? If the results are close, we may not know who the winner is for days or even weeks. So an important English word for today is patience. Patience.
Patience.
We all have to have patience. For more photo descriptions, check out one of these videos.